Welcome to Bert Ridgeway's Learning for Life video lessons, and in this clawhammer lesson we are going to be doing some practicing chords in our scale up the neck and down the neck, so that next week we're going to start Christmas in July. We're going to be using these patterns quite a bit. We're in standard G tuning. All the tunes will be in standard G tuning for this lesson and for the month of July. The reason I'm giving you the lessons for Christmas in July is most people put out their Christmas stuff in November or October, which gives you very little time to really get the tunes down where you're comfortable playing them. And I wanted to give you 6 solid months of practice time so that when Christmas rolls around, you'll be ready to go. So this will be in preparation for that and for other songs that we play in G tuning. Before we start, I want to thank my patrons who are such a blessing and a help to me. I could not be doing these without these lessons without their help. If you're watching these lessons, it's because somebody is giving, oftentimes sacrificially, to keep these lessons going and allowing me to help pay my bills and things of that nature, just so I can concentrate and focus on getting these lessons out. So I want to thank my patrons first and foremost. Thank you to those who are watching. So what we're going to do is I'm going to show you some chords that go all the way up to the 12th fret, which is your octave in G tuning. And we're going to start, and we could just go. But I don't want to do it that way. I want to teach you the chords. So you're going to hit the 3rd string open, and you can pick strum. It's just going to be a simple bum ditty. Make a D7. And what you're playing, what your melody note is this 2. So open, 2. Then you're going to play the 3rd string, or the 2nd string open. Then 2nd string 1st fret. So if you're playing chords, you're playing G, D7, 2nd string open, D7. So you're playing 3rd string, 3rd string, 2nd string, 2nd string. Then open, 1st string, so I'm trying to keep my fingers out of the way. Then you're going to make your C chord, hit that 1st string. You're going to take that C position and slide it up to 3 and 4. And then 5, and you're going to drop your ring finger on the 2nd string at the 5. Now you can do it open, depending on the song. You may want to leave it up, you might want to put it down. Then I'm going to have you go backwards. 5, referring to the ring, 4, 2, open, make your D7, 2nd string, 2nd string open, 3rd string, make a D7, open. I would practice that slowly, up and back. Actually, learn it up, then learn it back, then learn it up and back, and then slowly start increasing your speed. But we're going to keep going. So let's go up to the five. Make sure this is memorized. And I wouldn't go on until this is memorized. So we're using our ring. We're going to go up to seven, drop the middle beside it. And if you notice, we're really playing with our ring finger. At least once we get to that first string. Because if you played it single strings, but see, we'd make our C. So I hope that makes sense. So let's continue from the five. So five, seven. You're gonna slide, just like you're doing your C chord, you're gonna slide your ring finger up to nine and drop your pointer finger, just like you were doing a C, on eight. Now, I do have tiny little markings. They're very hard to see, but you should have markings probably on your banjo on the side, and it's gonna be between the two dots. Slide that ring up to 10, drop the middle finger, and up to 12. Now we can go higher, that's as high as we're gonna go. And what you can do is, you could strum. Or what I would recommend is hitting the melody note. Strum, melody, strum, sorry, strum. So that's what I want you to work on for this week. This will give you plenty of practice for what we're going to get into, because so many of the songs you can see right there, which will be next week's song. But you want to get used to playing up and down your scale using the melody notes and the chords. So I hope you enjoyed that lesson. Not a long one. These are going to be easy for the most part, and I think you're going to really enjoy this. So thank you so much for watching. We will see you very soon on our next lesson.